My friend let me borrow this module. It's a Mutable Instruments Rings, except for it's a clone, actually, made by Blue Lantern. It's just a clone. It's kind of simulating acoustic instruments that have resonant characteristics. Some of the things you can get with it are very tubular bellish, just things that cause a lot of sympathetic vibrations around them with other strings or other bells. And it gets into plucked territory like harps and harpsichords. And you can even kind of get it to sound a bit like a Wurlitzer or a... It's probably closer to a Celeste. So anyways, I'm going to start turning some knobs. You got your brightness. I think it's just a low-pass filter. Just kind of brings in some of the higher harmonics. Then you've got the damp, which kind of works in tandem with the bright. It's sort of like an envelope. The structure over here, which seems to kind of spread out or make smaller the harmonics that it's creating. I don't know how else to explain that. And then the position is kind of simulating where you're striking it on the instrument. So, like, if it were a drum, it's striking it in the middle versus towards the edge. And it's got monophonic, dualphonic, which is what we're in, and polyphonic. So, this is how it sounds in polyphonic, which is usually what I keep it on. You got four notes in polyphonic, so it can strike up to four, and then a fifth note will take over the first note. And then monophonic. And then you've got three modes here. I forget what they're called, but I'm kind of in the, woody mode. Thank you. then there's mode 3. And then here you've got this giant ass tuning knob, which I'm always bumping. I would replace it with a different knob, but it just looks cool. And it's got a pretty far, it's got a pretty wide frequency range. And then the other thing is, for every setting, there's a... For every one of these knobs, there's a CV control and an attenuverter. When the frequency isn't plugged in, it acts like a course.
Structurally, there is no discernible difference.